Actually, a cool thing you can do with a mirror shield is you can reflect their tacos or their burritos. I don't really know what they're shooting at you. They're shooting something Mexican, because on BPL's channel, we're racist. That's just how we roll. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the very next episode of Legend of... Anyways, what a fail way to start this video. In the last episode, we went into Turtle Rock and we went through some very annoying mazes, but we made our way out, and now we're going to Ganon's Tower. Oh, I hate these things. Ganon's Tower, which is the last dungeon before the real boss fight with Ganon. Did you see that? Did you see how good I am at this game? There's another freaking... I hate those things. I don't even know what they are, but they annoy me because they're like, "Rawr, I'm a lion, man, wildebeest." So you go over here to the left, and it says, "BPL, we are going to break the barrier of Ganon's Tower with our power." Oh, that was some good rhyming. I have to admit, that was pretty epic, I'm not gonna lie. So a quick note about this particular dungeon. Not only is it probably the worst one in the entire game, by worst, I mean meanest. There are also various ways that you can complete this, so following mine isn't the only way to do it, it's just the way that I've always preferred to do it. Now that I've said all of that, let's jump into this video. It is 2:30 in the morning, I am tired. I am so tired. And this is such a mean dungeon, I am so mean to myself. What you're gonna wanna do as soon as you go into this room is pick that up, and I like to kill him just because he annoys me. And you're probably wondering, what do you do here? And, well, I kind of showed you. Gotta hit the Diglets. Just smack them with your hammer. Don't hit the bumper, because the bumper is mean. Once you do that, right there, the holes will disappear, and you will be able to go through. So, guys, I know it has been a little while since I've updated the episodes in this video. I think maybe a week, if something like that. I've been just so... not wanting to do this dungeon. I've literally been putting it off. And you're gonna see why, because... whore? This takes so long to do this. And I might actually have to split this up into two videos, which I don't mind if I have to, but... that is going to increase the length of this Let's Play. Now, as I was saying... go to the right! Avoid those. So, the really, if you are doing this, you don't have to get the map or the compass. I am just doing a 100% run. So, I want to- oh, shit! Okay. Well, that's one way you can do it. I don't recommend doing that, but that is one way you can do it. You're gonna want to grab a bomb after you do that, and we need these tiles to go up, so that's the only reason we're doing that, because if you had gone in here, you'd been like, oh, snap, I'm stuck, although you may have been able to somehow get it. And if you swing your sword, that thing is gonna shoot fireballs. That's very annoying. What you need to do here... it's slightly tricky, but I think if you go right there... there we go. You have to make sure that... oh! What's up? You have to make sure that the blast only hits one of those, or else it'll... you know, say if we had it like this, and you hit it both of them, these would go down, and these would go up, but then these would go up again while these went down, because it hit both of them. So that's why you have to put the bomb in a very particular place. It's not too bad. Once you get used to it. So, I hate this dungeon so much, so much. Leave me alone, evil metal sphere. Not spheres, because they're not spheres. Evil metal spikes. You are so mean. So, I think a lot of people don't understand how mean this game really is. Because if you had played this without, you know, watching a playthrough, or having a guide, you had been like, oh Jesus, where do I go? You go to the left. I am making no sense. You go to the left again. You go down. You go to this one. You go down. And then that's pretty much the end of the maze. We just have to do one more thing. A cool thing about this is if you use your grappling hook on these guys, you can walk through them, so don't feel the need to go around them and fall in the holes, because I thought that when I played this when I was a small lad. If you need any arrows, don't know why you would need them. They're right here. And also, thank you guys to everyone who's been answering my random questions about little things about this game I didn't know. I was like, I don't know if these arrows actually do more damage, but in fact they do, so that is great. And I prefer... No. I prefer to just do this to these guys. Makes everything so much easier. You want to... We are gonna kill these hoes. You want to pick up the skull closest to the door over here. You're gonna see why in a second, because we're gonna be whipping out our fire rod. Now, normally, if you haven't played this game as much as I have, before going into this dungeon, I probably should have said this at the beginning of the video, I would highly suggest that you pick up some magic potions, or, you know, just blue potions. I think those heal both health and magic. Gimme. Thank you. Because this is a really mean one, but there are a lot of fairies scattered throughout the level, so you shouldn't have too much of a problem. But once you get that, you fall down here and we meet our old friends, the Armos Knights. So we are going to be fighting the three bosses that we first fought in this game, but with little twists to them. And actually, the last one we're going to be fighting is the easiest. This one isn't too bad if you just stay in one spot and there you go. With the silver arrows, everything is about 70% easier. Make sure you go in this room up in the top, because if you don't, you won't get the big key, and... Well, you know what's gonna happen if you don't get the big key. You won't be able to go through doors. Which sucks. I am abnormally unfunny, that's what I was gonna say. There is a room in here... Well, I thought there was a robber in my house, but apparently it was just my mother. So anyways, back to the game. If you go through that door that I ran into, there are some fairies in there, but we don't need any of those because that is how boss we are. Now here is, I hate this armor. We find the red mail, which is amazing. It is so much better than the blue mail and especially the green tunic, but the only problem is how it looks. It looks so horrible. I can't even begin to explain how much I hate this. So you'll notice now that we're back in this annoying room, but I do want to show you something. I just totally burped right there. Well, I can't show you because I killed him, so... what I was going to show is if you try to attack one of those guys and you miss, you know, he throws a bone at you and he's like, bitch, don't you do that to me. You actually will take no damage from that bone. That is how much better, how much more superior this is. Not making any sense. That's how superior this armor is to this. Now, what are we going to need for this next room? I think we are just gonna need this. So this is the worst, actually this is the second worst room in the game for me. Not only, you stupid anti-fairy. And you're probably thinking, BPL, why don't you just get rid of the anti-fairy? Well, the thing is, I'm most likely going to get hit by these tiles, so I want to have that there. And then, you know, I can heal myself. The worst part about this is if you try and attack, those little fire things will go down. And the wall master will take you back to the beginning of the dungeon. Leave me alone. Okay, can do this, can do this, can do this. Oh god, oh god. No. There we go. Boom! Oh. See, now that we saved it, we can replenish our hearts.
Yes.
That was hot. And now we can go to the next room. Now this room is actually where I raged about 50 times, not even joking. See what I mean? See what I mean? I got hit by that so many times. You have no idea how angry I was. First thing you're gonna wanna do in this room, I could have showed you right there, but I didn't. Okay, or I could take damage, that's great. So anyways, as I was saying, the first thing you're going to want to do in this room is clear out all the enemies, because if you don't, it is going to be nearly impossible to traverse. Of course, you can do it, but everything is about 100 times more difficult. Don't get hit by that thing. Found it easier if you do that, then that, and run. Now, that is probably the most annoying one in here. And you have to be careful because I actually had one of these guys slip through these cracks. I don't know how he did it. He must have been hacking.
What a hacker.
Yeah, it was him, jerk. Not what I meant to do. What you have to do is you have to take this, get it up there, and ooh, God, back up, ho. Then, you have to do it again. Now, you can't actually use a bomb on this, because maybe I fail at life, but I tried to use a bomb on it, and it did not seem to work. When you get into this room, you want to be careful, because you can only open the bottom left, bottom right, and top right chests. I'm not going to tell you what happens if you don't do them. You don't have to do them in that order, just these are the chests that are safe for now. And then once you get the top left one, that's what happens. So that's why you want to get the other ones first, just to be a greedy bastard. Voice cracked. How am I 19 and my voice still cracks? That's what I want to know. That is what I want to know. So anyways, once you do that, you want to use your magic mirror and go all the way back. And guys, this is live commentary to everyone who was like, that's not live commentary, you're an actor! And I'm like, what? No? What you talking about? I make videos. That's what I do. So this is kind of annoying, because you got these stupid, ow, mouse people. And you can get stuck, like, if you press the switch right here. Actually, I'll just show you. Yeah, you can get stuck there and you'll take damage and stuff. It's really annoying, but it's not too bad. If you push this down, go over here, hit that one. I might actually be able to make this into one video. I'm gonna be very proud of myself. Uh-oh, see? I got stuck. There we go. If I can make this into one video, you know, if it's less than 25 minutes, I think I'll upload it as one video, but if it's about 30, I'll probably just do two, although I would prefer to do one video. Because if I do one video, I can get the rest of them out to you guys faster. Because there is going to be the final boss fight after this video, and then I want to do a little bit of a, you know, little secrets in the Zelda game. Now, for some reason, I always get slow down here. I don't know why. Oh. There we go. Well, that worked out. Bypass him, and now we're coming into another room where we have to kill stuff. Always fail here. I hate these rooms so much. You're gonna... Okay, you get right here. I'm making no sense. You get right here, and you're like, oh, hey. Oh, he's mad. You mad? You mad, bro? Bro, you mad? He's so mad, bro. You get here and you see these statues, you see the big key door, and you're like, oh, we must be super close, and no, you're not even... how did I get hit? Whoa! Ow, 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 why am I not using a cape? I do have 3 fairies. You're going to want to make sure that you come in here with fairies. As I was saying, that one wall that you dash into, there are fairies in there, so you can restock up on those. But I am a hardcore tryhard. I don't need that stuff. That is how cool I am. You're going to be going up against the Land Mola soon, but the thing is, they die so much faster. Oh, wait. Screw you, ho. So, I'm going to swing at him. As you can see, we took no damage, which is great! Unless you take so small damage that you can't even notice it. Which I highly doubt it's that last one. This one's kind of annoying, as you can plainly tell, because he's on a freaking thing. And he is angry. I mean, look at him. Wish you could kill those things. I'm pretty sure you can't. And if you have been able to kill these things the entire time I've been playing this game, I am probably going to rage. Just saying. Don't shoot me, bro! Oh god, oh god! I hate this dungeon so much, and it keeps getting worse! Oh god! BPL, why don't you use your magic cape? Hey you, why don't you shut up? Ow! Ow! You freaking alligator mohawk slut! Ow! Have I- Why won't you die?! Go, go! Oh my- No! No, 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 no! Metal Gear Solid! Why did I say Metal Gear Solid? Even I don't know! I can... Oh god! I'm gonna make it! Oh! Oh! You know what? Stupid spinning circle star pentagon. You die. I think everything I said was incorrect. Come here! Stop the beeping! All right. God, that was annoying. Okay, so this is actually not that bad. The only thing you have to worry about... Ooh. It's getting hit by rocks and this thing shooting you. Which isn't too... How did... I'm pretty sure these guys only take 3 hits now, so you don't have to worry about... You know, really... There we go. About really, you know, messing up, because they die pretty fast. If you have all the upgrades, they die really fast. Now, just like in the original fight, when that guy jumps out of the sand, he's going to shoot 8 rocks, so you are most likely going to get hit. This game is so mean, they're like, we are not going to give you any health refills, you better be good and not suck at this game. And I am not particularly good at this game, so that is not great. But, we're just gonna trudge. We're gonna move on ahead. Now we're gonna be encountering Wizrobes, but I like to say that these guys are indeed Mexicans with wizard hats. That is also one way you can get rid of them. It also shows you where the flooring is. So I found that little trick out. Normally, when I actually first played the game, I was like, sup! That's not what I meant to do. When I first played the game, I used ether and I was like, oh, sup, I can see stuff now. And then the Wizrobes were like, sup. Actually, a cool thing you can do with a mirror shield, so you can reflect their tacos or their burritos. I don't really know what they're shooting at you. They're shooting something Mexican, because on BPL's channel, we're racist. That's just how we roll. Oh, come on. All right. Owned. So you might find it easier just to do this. Oh, I mean to do that. Owned. Sloot. I'm so tired. Everybody dies! Oh, you didn't die. It's supposed to die. The floor actually starts to collapse too, which you will see in a second right there. That is so cool. Oh, I'm such a nerd. This room is a pain, to be completely honest, because you have to remove the skulls over here first. Alright, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do this. Not what I meant to do. It worked, though! It worked! Use that one. Oh shit, I didn't get rid of that one. No. Go down there, go, Link, go! Yes! Whew! Go up top real quick, because if you don't, you will get hit. And there is a magic refill right there. Screw you, laser eyes. Right when you get into this room, go down here. Now, you could have used your lamp for this, but I am just too cool for that kind of junk. And then I use the lamp there. That make no sense. So that's how you get through that room, quick and easy. And I would suggest... What the hell are you doing, Link? I told you to freaking use your stupid thing. Now, if you need bombs or arrows, the chests at the top do harbor them. We do not need them. Harbor? Why the hell did I use that word? Oh god, no! Alright, you have to be really careful about... this! Okay, I think that'll do it. I think... Yes! Ooh, actually, oh man, I think we are gonna make this in one video. I did not know that you could sprinkle magic powder on them, and they did that. I am so annoyed right now. Why did none of you watching my videos tell me this? The love for you people, I think it might be gone. I think it might be gone, and I'm not even joking right now. Nah, I'm just kidding. I love you guys. So you're gonna remember this guy. Oh! Okay. On the spikes. On the spikes, really. Phew. Okay, you know what? I wasn't going to... Ooh! I really wasn't going to do it, but now I am, because you pissed me off, you stupid... Like, damn it! I don't know what's happening. My screen's black. Alright, so my screen went black, which is terrible. Because it went on standby. Oh man, it's so difficult getting this freaking thing. We're gonna cut him off. Yes! Alright. So the boss, I don't remember what his name is, Mr. I touch you once, you fall and die. I think he only takes 2 hits to kill. This is why he's nowhere near as bad as the other one. See? That's all I gotta do to kill him. Now, unfortunately, knowing myself, I failed miserably. Right when I stepped into this room, because he hit me. And I fell. And because the game is so nice, here's more rubies that we do not need at all. Now, I'm pretty sure there is... This is actually the last room before the boss. I can't believe we're already there. And I wanted to point out something. I completely forgot to do this. When you fight Aghanim, after you know you get the three pendants in the Light World and you get the Master Sword, you can defeat him when he's shooting his, you know, magic ball thingies at you. You can defeat him with the bug-catching net. You know, you can reflect it at him, which we are going to be fighting Aghanim here again. Butterfly, you know, butterfly net. You get it? It's pretty funny, right?
Oh, ho, ho. It's great that you could come all the way here, BPL. I'm very happy to see you again, but you'd better believe that we will not have a third meeting.
Oh, snap. He split himself in dose. Trace. To split himself in something. So, ow! I was going to use the bug catching net, but when I like streamed it with Tyler, I failed miserably, so I am just gonna stick to using the sword. Now, I don't know why, but I fail really hard at this, and I honestly have no idea why, but it should only take about 6 hits, I think, to kill this guy. It's really not that difficult. It's actually a very easy boss fight. Especially if you have the red mail. As you can see, I've barely taken any damage. Okay, how did that not hit him? Come on. Boom! Am I gonna really die to this guy? And you can hit him with the other guy's, you know, balls. Oh god. Come back here, you stupid bat thing. Okay, now that looks like Crobat. I don't care what you guys said. That looks like Crobat. Sluts. Oh, snap. He's evil, so he's a bat. And then... Foosh. Here we go, guys. This is the very last part of this game. I cannot believe that we're already at the end of this Let's Play, but... I want to thank everyone who's been watching so far. Had so much fun doing this. I will see you on the finale of Let's Play Legend of Zelda: A Link to the Past. My name is Banana Pylord.